Hello everyone, my name is Ever Barbero, and today I'd like to talk about example 6.5 in my textbook, Finite Element Analysis of Composite Materials Using Abaqus. This example is similar, yet simpler than example 6.3. Here we use computational micromechanics to calculate the effective properties of a laminate, using a representative volume element, RVE, to simulate the laminate, and applying boundary and constraint conditions to simulate the periodicity of the RVE. To create the part, we create a volume, 3D, deformable, solid, by extrusion. First we draw a rectangle, on the XY plane, at Z equals 0, which is at the middle surface of the laminate. Then we extrude it through only one half the thickness of the laminate, because the laminate is symmetric. Now we create datum planes, later to be used for partitioning the volume into laminas. Now we partition the volume into four laminas. For 3D modeling, the properties of each lamina are those of an orthotropic material, with 9 properties, but a fiber-reinforced lamina has only 5 properties, so some are repeated. Now we assign material orientation to each lamina. Theta equals 0, axis 1 is light blue, points along X, axis 2 is yellow, points along Y, axis 3 is red, points along Z. Axis 1, light blue, is the fiber direction. Now create a section, never mind 3D solid elements do not require any section properties, we have to do it anyway. Now assign the section to regions, or laminas in this case, to tie the material properties to the regions. Still in module assembly, create an independent instance of the part. Now create a linear perturbation step. Now adjust the field output request, to include the integration point volume data, that we need later to calculate the average stress. Now the boundary conditions. First, we clamp the face y equals 0, except along the direction z, so that the laminate can contract through the thickness, due to Poisson's effect. On step 1, we apply u1 equals 1, on the face y equals 1, which is a tangential displacement, perpendicular to y and parallel to x. This is our way of applying a unit shear strain, gamma xy. Oops, we used the wrong name. Let's rename it. Now apply symmetry boundary conditions to the middle surface, to tell Abaqus that the laminate is symmetric. Now we apply tie constraints between the face at x equals 0, master, and x equals 1, slave. We must choose node region, not surface, otherwise the state of stress will not be pure shear. With node region tie constraints, all displacements at x equals 1 are equal to those at x equals 0. Now we mesh, careful to choose element shape, hex, and meshing technique, sweep, so that the nodes on the two tied surfaces, get exactly the same coordinates, except for x. Now create a job, and submit it. When completed, click results. Save the .cae file, and run the Python post-processing script, ex6.5 post.py, available on my website. Set the work directory. Open the ODB. Initialize a frame repository. Define the global coordinate system. Stress transformation to common system. Populate the frame repository. Accumulate results. Calculate the volume average stress. And print the result. It runs instantly, and here's the result. G12 equals 21441 MPa. The load applied at the top should produce a shear stress, right? Well, it does, but the value is different for each lamina because Abaqus reports the stress in lamina coordinate system. We have another video that shows how to get results in global coordinates. Just looking from another angle, we can see here that the stress, S12, and thus the strain, E12, are pure uniform shear, as we wanted, in order to compute the shear modulus, G12. Okay, that's it for today. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe. You can find more details in the textbook, by following the link in the description. Thank you.